I'm waving.
Hey everybody, and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing a hair review on the hair that I have in right now. And this hair is coming from the company rpghair.com. If you're not familiar with the company, I will leave a link to their website below in the comment box, as well as a link to this particular unit if you decide you want to purchase it. So when I got my package, this is what it looked like. I believe my package came to me maybe 2 to 3 days after I actually placed my order. So it was very quick shipping. And then on the box, it also has the barcodes where you can scan your phone if you decide to pull up the website that way. So inside my package, obviously I had my hair, which came in this plastic casing. And on the front just has a sticker with the specs for you. So the hair is a natural hair color. It is 18 inches long, 180% density, and the actual texture of the hair is a natural body wave. The style of this wig, I will leave in the comment box below, but it is LFW31, and it is a 360 degree lace front wig. So that means there's lace all around the perimeter and in the back. I believe there's 4 inches of space and of lace on the top and 2 inches in the back. It has two adjustable combs on the top, excuse me, not adjustable, two combs on the top, or actually three combs. There's one in the middle, two on the sides, and then a comb in the back, as well as the adjustable straps that most wigs come with now. I did go ahead and sew on a strap, an elastic strap, to help hold the wig in place or have a more secure feel to the wig. So that I did do. Now, this hair I've had for about 2 or 3 weeks. I wanted to give myself time to actually wear the hair and find out whether or not I enjoyed it or I felt it was not worth my purchase. So what I've done in order to get this video together for you is I basically videotaped step by steps of my process of this hair, meaning when I first took it out the pack and put it on my hair, once I cut the lace off, and my initial impressions of the hair, and then my final impressions of the hair now that I've actually wore the hair. So I'm just going to go ahead and start this clip and let you see what my thoughts on this hair. Okay, so this is the hair right out of the box. What I went ahead and did to this wig is I went ahead and bleached the knots of the wig, as well as co-wash and wash the hair, and that's all I've done so far. This is what it looks like when you first throw it on your head out of the box. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut the lace off of this wig and tweeze the edges, and then I will be back to show you what I have. Okay, hey everybody. So I am basically putting this whole video together with a bunch of different clips because I want to be able to show the full process of and my experience of doing my first frontal. So right now, this is what I did last night when I first put the wig on, which you'll see the clip about that. You had just seen that. So this is what I actually end up doing, but I don't really like the way it looks. So I'm actually about to go back and play with it some more and straighten it and customize it a little bit more to my liking. But I did use the Got to Be gel. I used the yellow, the black, and the hairspray. So I used just a little bit of the yellow because the yellow leaves white residue. And then I used the black because the black is a clear gel. And then the hairspray as well, put a little blow dryer on it to help hold my edges down, and then slicked it back and laid the lace. Now I'm gonna come up closer so y'all can see what it looks like. But I suck at baby hairs, so this is what I'm about to actually go back and do, because I actually got some of the baby hair stuck when I was doing it last night. And I can't even lay my own edges for real in real life. So I'm about to go and look up a couple of different ways of laying my edges, come back and fix this. Cause your girl, I mean, it looks pretty natural. Like when I have, like I wore it out today
So it looks pretty natural, but I want it to look even more natural. So I'm going to fix my edges and push them back a little bit. So the gel itself actually does a really good job at holding this lace front down. Like I said, I did glue it last night, wrapped it, slept with it. The lace didn't come up at all. Right here on the edge, it's coming up only because I kept brushing it right here at the edges to try to get the dry pieces of hair up. And a little bit on this side, the same thing, just 'cause I kept brushing the front, which it didn't bother me that was coming up right now because I plan to do it over and make it look better. But I did just want to come and show y'all what it looks like after I take it right out the pack, glue my edges or try to lay my edges down and before I actually style it or anything. So this is what we look like. Hopefully when I come back, the next clip, I'm going to be like, slay bitch, like hopefully we'll see. But anyways, I will be back and show y'all what I came up with. Bye. So my final review on this hair is I feel like this is a very good purchase. The hair has consistently given me life. I mean, this is my first lace front wig. It's my first 360 lace front wig. I've tried a synthetic lace front before. Didn't like the synthetic. It just looked fake. Wasn't working for me. This is years ago, but this wig I did like. I've been wearing it, like I said, probably 3 weeks. And what I've done was the first week I wore it, took it out, washed my hair, put it back in, took it out, washed my hair, put it back in. So I washed my natural hair and then I've washed this wig as well. So if this wig's been washed 3 times and this is how it still looks. As you saw in the clips before, the video, the natural wave still looks really good. And when I'm lazy and don't feel like flat ironing the hair, I will go ahead and do my natural, just wear it natural wave because it's very beautiful that way as well. I don't take this wig off at all unless I'm going through my washes. So what I do at night is I basically just wrap my hair like I would my natural hair. I put a bonnet on. And then if I have to touch up my edges, which usually I don't, I will put my scarf around my edges and then put my bonnet on and go to sleep. But for the most part, I haven't had any issues with having to reapply the wig as far as like from a week to week basis. Occasionally, if I've been messing with the hair too much or something, or if I end up getting it a little wet on the edges, I would have to go back in and apply some gel on my tabs, like on the corners. But this part of my hair, I have not had to reapply other than when I actually take the wig off to wash my hair. Now, taking the wig off is so easy. All you have to do is wet the edges of your hair. Water will pull, will make the gel tacky again, and it just comes off seamlessly. Washing it, it didn't take long for me to wash it and to get the glue out of it, so I wouldn't have like glue residue buildup. And washing the glue out of my hair was so easy. In the beginning of this video, I told you what I used to hold down this wig, but just to name it again, I've used the Got to Be Gel, the black one, the yellow, and the Got to Be Gel hair holding spray. That's what I used on this wig. And for the most part, I just really used the black gel and the holding spray. The first time I applied it, I did use the yellow, but the yellow does leave a white residue. And from that point on, I just started using the black gel, which does just as fine with the holding spray. So I'm gonna go ahead and stand up so you can see where it falls on me. I did end up cutting a little bit of layers into this hair. I'm just gonna back up a bit. So I did end up cutting a little bit of layers into this hair on the sides. Just a little bit of layers, as you can see, there's a little bit. I haven't curled the hair just because I just haven't been in the mood to actually wear curly hair right now, but I am 5'5", and this is where the 18 inches fall on me. Even when cutting the hair, I don't feel like I cut any of the length off because my layers, I made long layers. So I tried not to cut any of the 18 inches off because I wanted long hair. So this is where it falls on me being 5'5". And it's very flowy, as you can see, like no issues at all. Everyone who's seen the hair has loved this hair on me. So I really, really have enjoyed this hair. I can't really complain about it. I don't really have any complaints. The parting space is very nice. I've been able to wear it in a side part. I could wear it in a middle part if I want to. If I wanted to, I could pull it up, half down. But with this unit, I just haven't decided. I haven't really felt the need to pull it up, half down. I really just wanted a straight look. That's what I was going for, and that's why I got this unit. But just to show y'all really quick, you can get parting space all over this wig. So no matter where you want to part, you have parting space. I mean, obviously this parting space isn't as prominent as this one because this is how I set up my hair. I set it up to be a side part. But yeah, I love this hair. I think it's really, really a good buy. So if you are interested in getting this, then, you know, use the link below. You can see the layers that I cut. Use the link below in the description box. Again, I'm not affiliated with this company at all. This is my first time using them. I just really, really enjoyed this unit. And I'm definitely going to be buying me some more. I want to do a bob, so I will come back with a video when I make that. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you want to see more of my videos and my hair reviews, then make sure you subscribe. Bye. Just taking it slow, babe. Somebody show me that door.